And again, you are touring a lot. So,
yeah.
And in your travels, you've been interacting with more and more fans.
Yeah.
And what are some of the unique fan experiences that you've run into?
Wow. I don't know. Sometimes there's good and bad. But I'll just talk about some good. Just last weekend, I went to Southern Utah.
Mm-hmm.
And in my mind, just a bunch of Mormons live there. And I thought it would be pretty conservative. And it ended up being one of the most stunningly beautiful places. And the people really reflected how beautiful it was, the surroundings were. Mm. And, you know, and I ended up, the first night I got there, they all had camper vans and stuff. And we ended up drinking 3-2 beer, which I didn't even know what that was. But there's less alcohol, I guess, because it's such a conservative place.
Okay.
You can't get real alcohol, kind of. So we just had, like, you know, 19 3-2 beers before you feel anything. And it was, like, one of the weirdest experiences. There's all these people I'd never met before, but we were around a campfire. And, you know, it was great, though.
Okay, yeah. That sounds like, I mean, it really sounds like a lot of fun.
It was beautiful.
And what's one of the more odd experiences that you've had?
Odd experiences. Every now and then I get kind of, a weird fan or something that's, I don't know, because I don't want to sound mean, but, you know, when you can just tell a person is a little off or something, or,
you know. Well, different can be good.
Yeah. Oh, right. No, I love different. I love different, but sometimes...
Sometimes different can be scary, too.
Sometimes different can be a bit scary, or, you know, sometimes people will draw pictures, or sometimes people will get gifts, you know.
Okay.
And sometimes I've gotten, like, one concert ticket. And they say, well, I have the other concert ticket, so, but I've never met them, so they want us to go together.
Yes.
Or, you know, gotten flowers, or that's nice, I guess. But one time I got a USB, like a flash drive. And I open it up, and it's just like all these mocked together newspaper articles that probably were from Madonna or something, but somebody had, like, put Liz Clark in there, and I really still don't understand the purpose of that, and it was just sort of given to me, and then run off, and I'm kind of like, what was that, you know, and it would say, Liz Clark on David Letterman tonight, or something, you know.
Okay, well, that can be kind of fun.
Yeah.
So yeah. Just look at it as it was given in that spirit.
Yeah, yeah. Well.
So, is the first single off the disc out and getting a little bit of play now?
Well, the release date is at the end of this month, and there is going to be a little radio play on it in college radio stations for, you know, starting about now for the next 8 weeks or something.
Okay.
And so yeah, I'd say if you have a college radio station that's around, then
okay, which song should they be requesting?
They would be requesting
first anyway, because I'm sure they're all going to be hot requests,
right? Yeah,
eventually.
They could request a song called Feet on the Ground.
Okay.
Let's say, if they liked it. But, yeah, there are a couple places.
When I first listened to it, it took me away. And I really enjoyed it a great deal.
Thank you.
So, and I'm sure the audience will also. Well, where can people find out a little bit more information?
My website is a good place, and that's LizClarkMusic.com.
Okay.
I have no E on the end of Clark. Some people do that. And I have a MySpace page. A lot of people like MySpace. And that's myspace.com/LizClark.
Okay. And, well, we have the www.talkingabout.info website. This show is going to be posted up there. And those two links will be right below the show on the page.
Great.
So when people visit your site, what kind of information can they find there?
They can find when I'm playing next. And then I also have kind of a fun journal page where I put up blogs and random musings of my life or illustrations or whatever, silly videos and stuff that I do.
So do you do most of the content on the site yourself? Is it all?
I didn't design it.
Okay, but
yeah, I usually upload all the stuff, and, you know, I'm pretty in charge of
all that.
Okay,
so it's really you is what I'm saying.
Yeah, well, especially the journal page, because I can do that pretty easily. So yeah, it is. Yeah.
Okay, so again, the website is?
LizClarkMusic.com.
And MySpace.com/?
Liz Clark.
Okay.
No music on that one.
So check out our page, www.talkingabout.info. And again, through that, you can get to both of Liz's pages. And you're going to be performing for us in just a second.
Yeah.
So I'm going to thank you very much for being here, and
we're gonna
have the audience just blink for a second in a moment, and then you'll be in the wink of an eye set up to perform. So thank
Don't
you
go
again.
Anywhere.
Don't go anywhere. Quick as a flash.
Yeah.
Okay, be right back.
Thank you.
You're a knife deer and hot butter. We're out here shooting ducks on a pond. We work, dear, for one reason. Ain't no other place that we belong. I wanna take you to a place where it's quiet. Sit back and watch the sun go down. It'd be so nice to get out New York City. Finally find a place to just hang around. Not enough. When you look, try to keep it downright. Keep it on the ground, keep it on the ground. Maybe I'm a rich man too. My feet are on the ground. Now I'm sitting in my apartment. I call you up to say I miss your eyes. Two different time zones, two different countries. I go to bed while you watch the sunrise. I know it ain't quite a fairy tale, honey, but people still would kill for what we got. We'll settle down maybe outside in the country. Get through this, we'll come out on top. And I'm not that heavy when you look, try to keep it downright. Keep it on the ground, keep it on the ground. Maybe I'm a rich man too. My feet are on the ground. Maybe we'll meet on the other side. Cause I just can't believe in the morning you put so much work in. At night you just go to sleep.